badass setup.
Powerhouse lithium.
All right, so as you guys can see, we went with Ionic lithium.
I have switched this year to Amped Outdoors lithium batteries.
All right, so that last review got a few folks fired up. There's some information that I was able to find out since the last video, so I'm gonna update you with that, and let's get into it. We're gonna cover Powerhouse, Impulse, Amped, Ionic, Battleborn, Wise, Eco-Worthy, LI Time, Dakota, Tracker, Dr. Prepare, Monster Marine, and Roy Pal. We are going to be looking at five key attributes today, and that's going to be cost, weight, Bluetooth connectivity, BMS, or battery management system, basically the protection of the battery, as well as the warranty. The warranty is going to be a big one, so stick around for that one. Let's talk about what's all common with these batteries. Set a baseline before we get too much further. First one is they're all 12.8 volt, 100 amp hour batteries, or 1280 watt hours if you're looking at it in watt hours. They're all 1C discharge rates. So when you're pulling power from that battery, you can pull up to the full one capacity or 100 amp hours. No more than that, really, for any length of time. But you can pull anything less than that, of course. Also, these are all lithium iron phosphate batteries. You may see them listed as LFP, LIFEPO4 batteries. These are not NMC batteries, which is going to be a little bit different chemistry. They're more NMC is a little bit more energy dense, reduced cycle life. They're also a little more volatile of a battery, not as safe as a chemistry as LFP. I'll link a video down below to explain that one. So let's get into it. First thing first, when you talk about a lithium battery, people always get to cost, right? Cost is one of the big ones here, so let's start there. For today, there's really two distinct tiers when we're looking at these. You got like that $280 range all the way up to $350. That covers five or six batteries here, and then all the way up to $875 when you're looking at the Battleborn batteries. So a wide range of cost here. If you're looking at the Dr. Prepare all the way to the left, you can buy two of those. That would get you to $600 range, and you're still less than, you know, majority of these batteries. So keep that in mind. There's other features that we'll talk about that differentiate it, but cost is a big one here. The second thing we're going to talk about is weight. Weight is the other one, right? So you're wanting to get rid of your lead acid battery or your AGM battery, cut some weight out of your boat, maybe pick up a little speed. Maybe you're tired of hauling a heavy battery around. So weight is also on here. And just remember, that's a huge difference when we're comparing like types of batteries, right? Lead acid versus lithium. Weight is a big deal. When we're comparing lithium to lithium, weight doesn't always tell you the whole story. So you'll see we go all the way down to 23 pounds, all the way up to 32 pounds, a 9 pound difference between the lightest and heaviest. I'll link a video below where someone did a capacity test on a Battleborn battery. They were able to get more than the advertised capacity out of that battery. So what that's telling me is there's probably another couple extra cells. Maybe that's just the way it laid out in the packaging. And so sometimes the extra weight gets you a little bit higher, or make sure you hit that advertised capacity. But do know, if you're lugging around the battery or you're in a kayak or something and you're super weight sensitive, the lighter batteries there are shown on the left. Oh, let's talk battery management systems. All of these have over voltage protection, short circuit protection, low voltage cutout, and high voltage cutout. But one of the big differentiating factors is low temperature charging cutoff. And what we're doing there is we're trying to avoid lithium plating of our battery, and we want to stop charging or really, really slow down the charge rate when it gets to freezing or below freezing. Otherwise, you'll cause lithium plating in the battery, and you will not be able to get that capacity back out of your battery, and it is forever gone. So it's very important that we get that right. When it comes to low temperature charging, you will find that most of your chargers really don't have any type of temperature compensation for the battery. As you get close to freezing, you want to really slow down your charge rate. So it's really up to the BMS, or the battery management system, to help protect you from that. Also, if you try to plug it in overnight and it's freezing cold outside, you want to make sure that thing's not pushing current to it while that battery is frozen. It does take a long time to freeze a battery. Don't get me wrong, like leaving it outside on a 32 degree night, that's probably not going to do it. It takes a long time to really freeze up a battery, but keep that in mind. So what we want to talk about here is we have the chart that you looked at previously. These are all lined up by the cost of the batteries. All the way to the left is the cheapest, all the way to the right is most expensive. And now we're going to color them. Ta-da! And let's talk through the colors. Gray means I have no information that cannot confirm nor deny low temperature cutoff. I think the safe assumption here is it does not, since they're not advertising it in any way. Yellow we'll talk about in a minute. Red means they do not have it. Either they told me directly, or their information says it does not. And then green, of course, is they have it. That's great. Let's talk about the yellow one first, the Dr. Prepare. Found a video from a year ago. Guy took apart the battery, did a low temperature test on it, and it failed, did not have it. Found another video where a guy took apart a battery, did another low temperature test a couple of months ago, and he did confirm that it has low temperature cutoff. So keep that in mind on Dr. Prepare. There's been some results going either way. Hopefully they've since corrected that, and you are good to go there. When it comes to companies that do not have it, we have Li Time Amped, which a lot of people push online, and one of the most expensive ones, Dakota Lithium, does not have it. Emailed them, no real rebuttal to that, no response, and it's also in their warranty manual. If you read it, if you charge their battery below freezing, you void that amazing warranty that they have on their battery. So you would think the battery would protect itself for how much they are, but apparently not. So let's talk about who does have it. Wise, Roy Powell, Ionic, Impulse, Powerhouse, and Battleborn all have low temperature cutoff to me. And this is at the 100 amp hour rating. Some of the smaller batteries do not, but to me, I would be picking from one of these batteries listed in green. Not really interested in one that doesn't have it. Something else worth mentioning is you don't want to charge these batteries below 32 degrees, like I mentioned, but Ionic specifically said that they have low temperature cutoff at 24 degrees. So I don't know why they decided to lower it below freezing, but something to know. They're a little bit different when it comes to low temperature cutoff. All right, next one up is going to be Bluetooth. That is a feature you may or may not need. It is definitely a nice to have, but not a must have, depending on how you plan on using your battery. About 40% of these batteries that are listed here do have Bluetooth connectivity. And speaking of percentages, 98% of my viewers are not subscribed. So if you're enjoying this video, hit the subscribe button for me. I'd really appreciate it. Anywho, it is certainly nice to have. And what that gets you is you can get your state of charge from your phone. You can get expected runtime. You can get amp hour remaining. You can get temperatures. You can label all your batteries to see what you have. Bluetooth is certainly nice if you have a multitude of batteries where you can see what your whole system is doing at any given time. That said, if you just got to have Bluetooth, the cheapest of the bunch, so Roy Powell battery actually has it for the $400 range. That's pretty good. Otherwise, you're kind of heading yourself up into that higher tier battery if you got to have Bluetooth. So that's going to be your Roy Powell, your Ionic, Monster Marine, Impulse, Powerhouse, and Battleborn. All have Bluetooth connectivity. Nice. We are now down to warranties, and that is also another hot topic when it comes to warranties. People get all excited about this one. Let's jump into it. So I simply cannot go into the details of everybody's warranty. They're all going to be a little bit different, but I'm going to try and cover some of the high level ones, some of the most popular ones, so that you are equipped with the information that you need, or you can go find what you need to make a good decision. Here's the best way I can represent this. So what we have is all the batteries lined up. They're bucketed by their warranty range, and the different color bars are how they're tiered. Either they're full coverage or they're prorated first tier, prorated second tier, whatever it might be. That's the way we're representing it here. So I'll start out with Powerhouse, since they tout a super awesome 15-year warranty. I'm going to oversimplify their warranty a little bit. 0 to 5 years looks like it. They're gonna fully take care of you. Really not a whole lot of concerns there with minimal red tape. Years 5 to 10, you're gonna send your battery in for repair. So you need to consider whatever downtime that is to put it in transit. And you need to consider that turnaround time for you. For years 10 and beyond, you're pretty much gonna get a 30% discount code for that. So I don't know if that meets your expectations for what a 15-year warranty is. But do know for those last 5 years on the Powerhouse that it's a pretty much a discount code. Next one up is going to be the 11 years, and that's going to be the Ionic and Dakota. Ionic has a three-tier warranty here. First 5 years is full coverage, so repair it. You will have to send it in, however. Years 5 through 8, you'll get to send it in as well for that, but you pay $150 service fee. So depending on the cost of the battery, you can jump it up another $150. And then years 8 through 11 is also a 30% discount code. So keep that in mind when it comes to comparing warranties. Some of them are just discount codes at the end. In the 10-year bucket, we have some low-cost options there with Wise and Dr. Prepare. If you have an issue with one of these lower-end, cheaper batteries, you may struggle with getting some warranty support on it. They don't always have the best U.S. representation, so keep that in mind if it's not, you know, a door you can go knock on, essentially. That you may have a challenge getting it warrantied. So keep that in mind. That said, some of these batteries are half the cost of the other ones. So maybe it's worth the gamble. That's up for you to decide, but I want to arm you with the information you need to make a good decision there. Battleborn, it has a 10-year warranty. We can also take a look at the first 8 years as repair or replace, free of charge. And then years 8 to 10 is up to their sole discretion. They can fix it. They can not fix it. If they don't fix it, they'll send you a 30% discount, like the other guys, towards a new battery. So keep that in mind when it comes to the Battleborn warranty. So unfortunately, we don't have time to go through all of these in the same amount of detail, but hopefully you're armed with the right type of information that you can go search through the warranty manuals, get an idea of what you're looking for. And with that, I ended up going with the Wise battery myself. It meets my price point. It meets what I need from a capacity standpoint. There's a teardown video I'll link below, shows it has great quality within it. Also has low temperature cutoff. I don't particularly need the Bluetooth connectivity for my application. With that said, it's currently working out for me just fine. If you're trying to figure out how big of a battery you need, please check out this video right here. And like I said before, if you haven't liked and subscribed, please go ahead and do that. We'll see you next time.